Doing good. Checking it out. We saw some of those Westboro Baptist Church motherfuckers around here.
Yeah. Still up there.
Are they right at the top?
Yeah.
Abortion rights are here to stay! Hey, hey! Ho, ho! Overturn the 19th Amendment, yo! Hey, hey! Ho, ho! Overturn the 19th Amendment, yo!
Let's go!
Your mother chose to have you! Thank her every day!
We appreciate that you're here, but we are planning this time, the longest time.
Your mother chose life! Be thankful for the gift of life!
Seattle does not support the presence of the Westboro Baptist Church. If you stand for hate, if you stand for limiting a woman's right to choose, we don't want you on these steps. If everybody down here, if you're a woman who slept with more than five men, you're loose, we don't want you around here either.
Ask people that are not supporting the
lead. No, if you're not supporting, we need you to leave. Starting with you, glasses and blue beanie. You gotta get out of my face.
What the fuck is wrong with you, man?
I'm not sure whose side I'm on yet. Let Jesus speak. Let Jesus speak. Let Jesus speak. Let Jesus speak. I am an insurrectionist! Jesus is coming through me now! Women should no longer be able to get their nails done on Sunday! No nails done on Sunday! This is my decree!
What do you guys want me to say? I'm for sale! I'm for sale!
Women's rights! Women's rights! They are something that's worth a fight!
Hey, this is assault, brother!
Arby's has the meats. A very good roast beef sandwich for a very low price of $4.99 with the purchase of a soft drink and fries.
This is capitalism at work.
Hey, hey! Ho, ho! Hateful assholes have got to go!
Come on. I was going after them this time.
Can I pay you $200 to say something?
Yeah, what do you want me to say?
I say, I have a big dick. Tell everybody.
The guy next to me has a giant penis. The man with the tiger shirt.
Yes!
Hey, you're jealous of it, buddy. You with the stud earrings, you're jealous of this guy's fucking hanger.
I'll say whatever you want.
Say anything.
I'm like a billboard.
What do you mean? I'll say anything.
Get the fuck out of here before you get your shit rocked.
Your language is foul, Mrs.
You're gonna get your fucking shit rocked if you don't back the fuck up.
No way.
I thought you guys stood for peace.
I don't give a fuck about
you.
Why
do you guys want to hurt him?
In the fucking throat.
He's just a billboard.
I'm Jewish, man.
He's just a billboard.
I'm Jewish. You're ugly. I know that's your only handicap.
You yellow bastard, come over here. We got an interview for the vlog. We're doing something on Seattle, please. You look like Inspector Gadget or April O'Neil from the Ninja Turtles.
Does Inspector Gadget wear all yellow?
Yeah, dude.
I thought it was a muted imperial tan.
You look like a highlighter.
It's hard to argue with that one. We're at the Capitol Hill Autonomous Zone.
Protesters in Seattle are holding several city blocks after the Seattle police vacated the area earlier in the week, called CHAZ, the Capitol Hill Autonomous Zone.
Well, formerly Capitol Hill Autonomous Zone, now just Capitol Hill. I guess Leo has really just shown us what the game is here.
Oh yeah, there's a lot of people to attack.
Have people been coming by and harassing the police station?
Not since we've been here.
You guys are just preemptively putting up bulletproof glass here?
This isn't bulletproof, this is a different type of product, but nice. We got called out this for coming to stop.
The liberals and the pussies around here, they don't use bullets. They throw bricks, empty latte cups.
Is this a hipster proof?
This is guaranteed to withstand a hacky sack that has been juggled three times and then instep droven into the glass.
Built to absolutely take any flannel that has been sunk in cement.
Was that a tactic they were using?
Yeah.
They were doing that?
Cement flannels.
Ah. Guaranteed to withstand 3 firm wraps with a messenger bag. It's the rooster! Yeah! What are you doing?
Yellow bastard!
Get over here!
Hey, come on, get in our video, dude. We've been searching for you all day!
Cock and doodle doo, motherfucker!
Highlighter fuck!
Wow, you look so dapper, my man.
Mm-hmm.
I looked over and I said, look, it's good-looking Joseph Gordon-Levitt.
Yeah, the real Joseph Gordon-Levitt is a hog. Are you headed anywhere? Are you going to close a deal right now?
Man, all I was closing out was this bottle of Maker's.
Whoa! You look like a professional alcoholic.
Thank you.
My man, wait, you just took a swig of that, didn't you?
Oh, yeah.
I demand you take another right now so we can see the real spirit of Capitol Hill.
A swig, buddy.
Little hangover
this is
cheer.
Your big day.
Just a little. My entire job actually is studying drugs.
Because you're an addict?
I study pharmacology.
Oh, wow. You want to be a pharmacist?
I try to help people who are addicts.
Okay. What advice do you have for that man right there?
Yeah, what advice do you have for the guy in the red there?
I don't know. Take an upper.
Take an upper.
What about sex, masturbation, porn?
That'll cure your homelessness pronto.
Think, yeah, if you nut enough, it may purge all the toxins in your body.
I think you're going to be a real good pharmacist, Matt.
You look like a young Professor Snape.
Thank you.
That is a compliment. I'm going to buy you something to drink out of, Matt. The Happy Panda's pretty good. This is your new whiskey drinking cup right here, Matthew. You're welcome.
That's a good whiskey.
You're welcome. Look at the amber quality of the liquid. It looks great in there. And Matt, you're being modest with this pour. You're being a little modest. Yeah, top that off for me.
Oh my God, you are a beast.
He didn't quite finish it, Leo.
No, well, he's got to finish it, he will.
Snape looking fuck.
That's how Leo does it. He intimidates people.
Yeah.
He shames people into drinking by comparing them to Harry Potter characters.
That's true, I called him Harry Twatter last night, all night.
I called him Ron Weasley, because Weasley's insulting enough on its own.
That is true.
Ron Weasley.
You know, you ever think about that, in the Harry Potter world, it's so offensive just to be called by your last name?
I know, Weasley.
Hey, Longbottom, Goyle, hey, Crabbe.
I don't know why you name your kid the last name Crab. Family name.
Yeah.
Short stack.
Yeah.
I call a short guy that.
That's not in the Harry Potter universe, Leo. It's okay. You're not much of a reader.
It's a little.
Hey, make Leo take a pull.
45% alcohol by volume.
What side did you put your dirty Snape lips on?
Nasty ass lips are right there.
And you look like Hagrid.
I do look like Hagrid.
Go tame Aragog after you drink this.
Yeah. God bless you guys. You have gained another subscriber.
Yes. One at a time. One at a time. Like the video, all of you who are already subscribed. Help us out. Help us reach a new audience beyond Seattle and the Capitol Hill Autonomous Zone. Yes, I'm leaving. Right now, we're gonna disrupt sports. Excuse me, everybody. I don't mean to disrupt the practice. My name is Michael J. Nicholson. I represent... I'm sorry, what was that, sweetie?
This is a very big disruption.
This is Leandro DiTavio. I think he'll be worth your time. He is an alumni of The Bachelorette Season 17.
Don't worry, guys.
I used to be an agent with CAA, honey. This is what I do for a living. We need him to give a speech here to motivate the ladies. I now operate a channel for him called DiTavio Delivers. He just advises people on various things. He doesn't know anything about any of them. He's a total incompetent. Yeah. He's gonna tell you, ladies.
Oh God, oh God.
Gary, we'll be honest, he's fallen on hard times since The Bachelorette. We've had to go to YouTube. He's been canceled a couple of times. But DiTavio Delivered, I think it's gonna be the Phoenix.
I've lived in LA for a while. We're all kind of from The Bachelorette. It's
You weren't on The Bachelorette. If you were on The Bachelorette, you would've gotten eliminated in the first round, though.
I definitely would've been eliminated in the first round.
He made it to 5. Today. Beautiful tennis court here.
Clay, right? Is this clay?
Yeah. Okay. Tell the camera right now why it's clay and how you know it's clay.
This is clay because in Seattle, during the inception of the tennis courts in 1972, there was a group of homosexuals that were really, really, really anti anything that wasn't clay. So they had a loud voice. They were part of the PTAs. They were part of the meetings. They were part of the HOAs. Soon enough, every court in Seattle happens to be clay. And Rafael Nadal was known to have sex on the clay courts prior to him actually winning the Masters.
How long do I have to stay here for this? Because, you know, this misinformation is, like, hard to listen to.
What kind of material do you think this is, Gary?
This is a composite hardcore.
See, that's where you're wrong. This, in fact, is clay. And Rafael Nadal used to have sex on it, the homosexuals, the PTA. Yes. End of story. DeTavio delivers. I mean, how are we going to make it take off?
We got a deadline.
Wait, you want us to go talk to the soccer guys?
Yeah. Should we go talk to them?
It's not us. I'm
sorry. All right, gotcha. We got you.
I'm so sorry.
Leandro, how about helping Gary with his swing?
Okay, that is your forehand or your back? That's your forehand.
Oh, come on.
I believe that is his forehand. Now, I'm going to say
That's correct.
I'm going to say this. Look. I can tell that he learned.
It's really hard to listen.
I can tell.
No, you need to listen to this. I saw your game, Gary. It was fine. It wasn't perfect.
It's clear to me that he learned that from the Serbians. And in tennis, that is kind of a farce.
We say, Gary, that the Serbians are all hair and no substance. It's the French you need to learn your swing from. Demonstrate the French swing.
Tell me your name again.
My name is
Leandro DeTavio.
Leo DeTavio from the Bachelorette.
Because you impressed me as all hair and no substance.
This is Leandro DeTavio.
How you doing, guys?
Alumni of The Bachelorette Season 7.
I was on The Bachelorette Season 14, but it's okay, boss.
Why don't you have a play with us for 2 minutes?
Oh, God. I got this friend you see, makes me feel not wanted for the night you skip. I'll rest myself.
Ooh, hit it! Oh, hit it!
Your forehand that you were showing me earlier.
Go ahead.
So the forehand.
Don't correct him, Gary. Come on.
It kind of dips real low first.
Are you just right-handed or left-handed?
I'm right-handed. Gary, I don't know why.
On the other side.
Gary, who's conducting this seminar? It's DeTavio.
It's a little offensive.
Gary, listen, this guy, I know he's not much for tennis. I know he's not much for brains. But this guy had two 22-year-old Seattle co-eds sharing his penis like thirsty birds at a fountain just last night.
I would say it was about 4 hours ago, Gary.
Well,
I haven't even showered.
Should be giving lessons on, not tennis.
Well, those are going to cost you, those lessons.
How do you do that?
Hey, everybody. I hope you love the channel. If you do, consider supporting us on Patreon. What's in it for you? Bunch of titties. That's what's in it for you right now. And also what's in it for you is it'll improve the production quality of our free content here on YouTube. Right now we have 2,741 patrons. Please help us reach our goal of 3,000 by the end of October. Thank you so much.
We're here at the original Starbucks, number one on the waterfront of Seattle. We've brought with us Emilio, who possesses, as you know, one of the most discerning coffee palates in the greater Bay Area of California.
Might be in the world, one of the best.
I think it's safe to assume he has never, believe it or not, tried Starbucks. A virgin tongue as far as Starbucks is concerned.
Now, Starbucks gets some flack, we all know that, but look at this line. Does this lie? Mm. Is this line lying?
It doesn't.
Look at all these people waiting for their coffee. Emotional, some of them.
Mm-hmm.
I saw a man over there, he was crying.
What is your name, sir? What's that?
Hey, you got some great hair, man.
I appreciate it today.
Do you want to use an alias? You're uncomfortable using your real name?
No, it's cool. My name's Michael.
You got a record, my man? It's okay.
I do not have a record.
Okay, so. We're good.
We don't believe you, but it's all right. Michael,
yeah,
this is Emilio.
One time he sipped some coffee. He tasted it. He knew it came from pine barrels.
Yep. And he knew, furthermore, that it was farmed on the island of Java.
Right.
He knew that. Not South American coffee, not African coffee, Javanese.
Right.
Yeah, and Michael? Knows. Emilio is gonna try his first Starbucks coffee today before your eyes.
Sometimes when I think a coffee tastes like shit, he loves it. Sometimes when I think it's the most amazing thing in the world, mm-hmm. he hates it.
Leo's more of a dark guy. He's right. More of a light guy.
He likes the blondes, you know what I mean?
Let me tell you, I've seen him handle a redhead too, Michael.
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, that's right.
Huh?
You sure can.
Let's see this. Right. Emilio, it's almost game time.
Almost game time.
We like to call him the roast master.
All right.
He is so advanced in tasting coffee and brewing coffee, but he has never tried Starbucks.
I'm sorry.
Oh, no problem. One second. He's going to try Starbucks for the first time. He's never tried. This is free promotion for the Starbucks Corporation.
Will you come from without a permit? If you need to come online, you need to contact our...
Can we go on the street?
All right. Starbucks Corp, we got to do something about Josh.
I know.
Fire the guy.
Sorry, sir.
Bad publicity.
I'm sorry. Can you stop with
me? Hey, Josh, be more like Skyler. Be more like Skyler.
Skyler was trying to push for the YouTube channel.
All right.
Loved it.
Emilio, your first ever Starbucks coffee.
Guys, take a look. Take a look.
Trying Starbucks for the first time ever. Yeah!
He didn't like it.
Josh didn't like the coffee.
Bland at all.
Emilio! What the H, dude?
What's wrong with you, dude? Why'd you spike the cough?
Michael, I'm sorry. Skyler, I'm sorry. Josh, I'm sorry.
Dude, I don't know why you spiked the cough
dude,
like that, man. Like,
what the hell?
Cough.
We were this close to hitting our 10,000 hours and getting monetized.
What the fuck is wrong with you, dude?
You pull something like that?
This is Beanie Babies.
You've gone rogue.
Business cards.
We don't have them. And Beanie Babies on YouTube. Hey, Emilio's going rogue. We brought him all the way up from Oakland. What?
It's a $10,000 to shoot here in the historical district, Pike Place Market. Would you cease and desist, please, without the permits?
Shooting here is a $10,000 fine in the state of Seattle.
I've heard that before.
Mm-hmm.
Shooting one of these is a $10,000 fine in the state of California.
I'm so happy, cause today found my friends in my head. I'm so ugly, that's okay, cause so are you. Look on me, it's Sunday morning, it's every day for all I care. And I'm not scared, light my candles in our days.
Hey, what's been happening with you and Beth?
Remember the small storage fire in my... It was going on in my backyard.
Yeah.
They happened to send some really fucking handsome fireman over. All right.
Well, Beth was home alone, watching the house and your dog.
Yeah. You hear what I'm saying? A fucking...
He used his fire hose and not the one that shoots water. On Beth?
Fuck Beth, dude. You fucked the shit out of Beth, dude. What are you guys laughing at?
Sorry. The hard times.
It's not funny, man.
Fiance, infidelities. We can get you another Chardonnay, but I want you to keep it together in there. Be civil. You're going to get one more, and then we're going to go back down to the ground floor.
Frankie!
Hey, are you drunk? Are you just playing?
No. He's doing okay. He's going through some hard times, Frankie, right now with his fiance.
Okay,
Frankie, my wife. Can I ask you a question, man?
Wait.
She fucked him. She fucked him, man.
Heavy pour, Frankie. Maybe one more pour.
Give me one more, please.
He's having trouble with his fiance, guys. Oh my God. No. Look what you did. You made Frankie have to mop up your mess.
Frankie, man, I'm sorry, man.
He doesn't get paid for this shit.
It's one of the lowest points of my life, man. It's just a fucking low point, man. I'm sorry.
We brought him up here to try to help him forget things, and it's all coming out the top of the space needle.
This guy's fucking, he's such a fucking good looking guy, man. I can't compete with that.
You're a handsome guy too.
I can't fucking compete with him, man.
Frankie, he's a handsome guy, isn't he? He thinks he's ugly.
Frankie, you think I'm fucking handsome, man? You promise me, man?
Frankie, would you fuck my friend Leah? Would you fuck him right up his ass?
Don't ask him.
You want to get out of here?
Let's get out of here.
You're doing great. Hey, man, can we get him one more drink to go?
I don't think so.
Let's go.
Space Needle sucks. Dude.
Everybody,
I'm sorry.
Make sure you trust your partner before you commit to something like marriage.
You fucked him, man.
Yeah. Threw up in my mouth a little bit. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Sorry, I'm just calling this Chris. Oh, shit. How you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm just a little hammered, man. My wife fucking cheated on me, man. And I had one too many drinks up there.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
First name,
Leandro. Leandro, my parents. They named me Leandro.
Okay, what's your last name, sir?
Dotavio.
Come on, buddy. Let's go. Come here. Okay. You fucking asshole. You sold that about three times more than I wanted you to sell that. You're lucky we didn't get a hefty fire department bill slapped on our ass.
Dude, they were my boys, dude. I got all those EMTs to give me a pound on the old fist before we left, and they were loving it.
So you've made peace with what they did to Beth.
Oh, yeah.